Hello everyone, welcome to Finance by Vishan Arpita. In today's video, we'll see moving averages. We have all learned about averages in school. Moving average is just an extension of that. Moving averages are trend indicators and are frequently used due to their simplicity and effectiveness. Before we learn moving averages, let us have a quick recap on how averages are calculated. Assume five people are sitting on a nice sunny beach enjoying a nice chilled bottled beverages. The sun is so bright and nice that each one of them ends up drinking several bottles of beverages. Assume the fine count be something like this. You can see in this picture. So you can see in this picture, assume sixth person walks in to find out 29 bottles of beverages lying around them. He can quickly get a sense of roughly how many bottles each of them consumed by dividing total number of bottles by total number of people. In this case, it would be 29 divided by 5. That comes out to be 5.8 bottles per head. So, the average in this case tells us roughly how many bottles each person had consumed. Obviously, there would be few of them who had consumed above and below average. For example, person E drink 8 bottles of beverages, which is way away the average of 5.8 bottles. Likewise, person D drinks just 3 bottles of beverages, which is way below the average of 5.8 bottles. Therefore, the average is just an estimate and one cannot expect it to be accurate. Extending the concept to stock, here are the closing price of ITC Limited for last 5 in 2014, last 5 trading sessions. So the last 5 day average could be calculated as 1719.75 divided by 5. That comes out to be 343.95. Hence, the average close price of ITC over the last 5 trading session is 343.95. So, coming to the first topic of the video, that is the moving average, also called the simple moving average. So, consider a situation where you want to calculate the average closing price of Marico Limited for the latest 5 days. The data, you can see, this is of 2014. So, 12.3 divided by 5, that comes out to be 242.5. Hence, the average closing price of Marico comes over the last 5 trading sessions is 242.5. Moving forward, the next day on 26 July and 27 July were Saturday and Sunday respectively, we have a new data point. This indicates how the new latest 5 days would be 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th and 28th. We will drop the data point belonging to 21st as our objective is to calculate 5th day average. So you can see here the average comes out to be 1223.3 divided by 5, that comes out to be 244.66. Hence, the average closing price of Marico over the last 5 trading session is 244.66. As you can see, we have included the latest data, 28th July, and discarded the oldest data, 21st July, to calculate the 5-day average. On 29th, we would include 29th data and exclude 22nd data. On 30th, we'll include 38th data point but eliminate 23rd data, so on. We are essentially moving to the latest data point and discarding the oldest to calculate the last day average, hence the name moving average. In the above example, the calculation of the moving average is based on the closing price. Sometimes moving average are also calculated using other indicators such as high, low, open. However, the closing price are used mostly by the traders and the investors as to reflect the price at which the market finally settles down. Moving average can be calculated for any day frame, from minutes, hours to years. Any time frame can be selected for the can be selected for charting software based off your requirement. For those of you familiar with Excel, here is a screenshot of how moving average are calculated on MS or Excel. Notice how the cell reference move in the average formula, eliminating the oldest to include the latest data point. You can see in this picture. As it is evident, the moving average changes as and when the closing price changes. As calculated in this figure, a moving average is called a simple moving average. Since we are calculating it as per the latest 5 days of data, it is called, referred to as 5-day SMA, simple moving average. The averages for 5 days, or it could be anything like 5, 10, 50, 100, 200 days, are then joined to form a smooth curving line known as the moving average line, and it continues to move as the time progresses. The chart shows I have overlaid a 5-day SMA over ACC's candlestick graph. So what does a moving average indicate, and how does one use it? There are many moving average applications, and shortly I would introduce a simple trading system based on moving average. But before that, let us learn about the exponential moving average. So what is the exponential moving average? Consider the data used in this example. When one calculates the average across these numbers, there is an unstated assumption. We are essentially giving each data point equal importance. We are assuming that the data point on 22nd July is as important as the data point on 28th July. However, when it comes to market, this may not always be true. Remember the basic assumption of technical analysis: market discounts everything. This means the latest price you see for 28th July discounts all the known and unknown information. This also implies the price on 28th is more scarred than the price on 25th. One would like to
assign weightage to data points based on the newness of the data. However, the data point on 28th July gets the highest weightage. 25th July gets the next highest weightage. 24th July gets the third highest weightage, and so on. By doing so, I have essentially scaled the data points according to its newness. The latest data point gets the maximum attention, and the oldest data point gets the least attention. The average calculated in the scale set of number give us the exponential moving average, EMA. I deliberately skipped the EMA calculation part simply because most of the technical analysis software let us drag and drop the EMA on prices. Hence, we will focus on EMA's application as opposed to its calculation. Here is a chart of Cipla Limited. I have plotted 50-day SMA black and a 50-day EMA red on Cipla closing price. Though both SMA and EMA are for a 50-day period, you can notice that the EMA is more reactive to the prices and the sticks closer to the price. EMA is quicker to calculate to the current market price because EMA gives more importance to the most recent data point. This helps the trader to take quicker trading decisions. Hence, for this reason, traders prefer the use of EMA over SMA. Now, coming to the third point of the video, a simple application of moving average. A moving average can be used to identify buying and selling opportunity with its own merit. When the stock price trades above its average price, it means the traders are willing to buy the stock at a price higher than the average price. This means the traders are optimist about the stock price going higher. Therefore, one should look at buying opportunity. Likewise, when the stock price trades below the average price, it means the traders are willing to sell the stock at a price lesser than its average price. This means the traders are pessimist about the stock price movement. Therefore, one should look at selling opportunities. We can develop a simple trading system based on these conclusions. A trading system can be defined as a set of rules that help you identify entry and exit points. We will now try and define one such trading system based on a 50-day exponential moving average. Remember, a good trading system gives you a signal to enter a trade and a signal to close out the trade. You can define the moving average trading system with the following rules. Rule 1, buy, go long when the current market price greater than 50-day EMA. Once you go long, you should stay invested until the necessary stay condition is satisfy. Rule 2, exit the long position square off when the current market price turns lesser than the 50-day EMA. Here is a chart that shows the application of the trading system on Ambuja Cement. A black line on the price chart is the 50-day exponential moving average. Starting from left, the first opportunity to buy originated at 165, highlighted on the chart as B1 at the rate 165. Notice at point B1, the stock price moved to a point higher than its 50-day EMA. Hence, as per the trading system rule, we initiate a fresh long position. We stay invested by the trading system till we get an exit signal, which we eventually get at 187, marked as S1 at the rate 187. The trade generated at a profit of rupees 22 per share. The next signal is to get long come at B2 at the rate 178, followed by a signal to square off at S2 at the rate 182. This trade was not as impressive, as it resulted in a profit of just rupees 4. However, the last trade at the rate B3 165 and S3 at 215 were quite impressive, resulting in a profit of rupees 50. Here is a quick summary of these trade based on the trading system fared. From this table, it is obvious that the first and the last trades were profitable, but second trade was not so profitable. If you inspect why this happened, it is evident that the stock was trending during the first and the third trade, but during the second trade, the stock moved sideways. This leads us to a significant conclusion about the moving average. Moving average works brilliantly when there is a trend and fail to perform when the stock moves sideways. This basically means moving average in its simplest form is a trend following system. From what you will notice from moving average, from my personal experience, I have noticed a few important characteristics. Moving average gives you many trading signals, buy and sell, during a sideways market. Most of these signals result in marginal profit, if not losses. However, usually one of those many trades result in a massive rally, like the B3 at the rate 165 trade leading to impressive gains. It would be tough to segregate the big wins from the many small trades. However, the trader should not be selective in terms of selecting inside. The moving average system suggests, in fact, the trader should trade all the trades that the system suggests. Remember, the losses are minimized in moving average system, but the one big trade is good enough to compensate for all the losses and give you a sufficient profit. The profit making trade ensure you are in the trend as long as the trend lasts, sometime even upon several months. For this reason, moving average can be used as a proxy for identifying long term investment ideas. The key to moving average trading system is to take all the trades and not be judgmental about the signals being generated by the system. There is another example of BPCL where the moving average suggests multiple trades during the sideways market. However, none of them were really profitable. However, the last trade resulted in a 67% profit in about 5 months. Now, coming to the fourth topic, moving average crossover system. as it is indicated, now the problem with the plain vanilla moving average system, it is that it generates far too many trading signals in a sideways market. A moving average crossover system is an improvisation over the plain vanilla moving average system. It helps the traders to take fewer trades in a sideways market instead of the usual single moving average. In a moving average crossover system, the trader combines two moving averages. This is usually referred to as smoothing. A typical example of this would be to combine a 50-day EMA with a 100-day EMA. The shorter moving average, 50-day in this case, is also referred to as the fast moving average. The longer moving average, 100-day moving average, is referred to as the slower moving average. The shorter moving average takes a lesser number of data points to calculate the average, and hence it tends to stick closer to the current market situation and therefore reacts more quickly. A long moving average takes more data points to calculate the average, and hence it tends to stay away from the current market price. Hence the reactions are slower. Here is the example of a Bank of Baroda chart showing you how the two moving averages stack up when loaded on the chart. As you can see, the black 50-day EMA line is closer to the current market price as it reacts faster compared to pink 100-day EMA as it reacts slower. Traders have modified the plain vanilla MA system with the crossover system to smoothen out the entry and exit point. The trader get far few signals in the process, but the chances of the trade being profitable are quite high. The entry and exit for the crossover system is as stated. Rule 1, buy fresh long when the short-term moving average turns greater than the long-term moving average. Stay in the trade as long as this condition is satisfied. Rule 2, exit the long position, square off when the short-term moving average turns lesser than the long-term moving average. Let us apply the moving average crossover system to the same BPCL example that we looked at. For the easier comparison, I have reproduced the BPCL chart with a single 50-day moving average. Notice when the markets are moving sideways, moving average suggests at least three trading signals. However, on the fourth trade was the winner, which resulted in 67% profit. The chart shows below the application of moving average crossover system with 50 and 100 day EMA. The black line point the 50 day moving average and the pink line plots the 100 day moving average. As per the crossover rule, the signal to go long originates when the 50 day moving average short term MA crosses over 100 day moving average long term MA. The crossover point has been highlighted with an arrow. Please do notice how the crossover system keeps the trader away from the three unprofitable trades. This is the biggest advantage of a crossover system. A trader can use any combination to create MA crossover system. Some of the popular combination for a swing trader would be 9-day EMA with 21-day EMA. Use this for short-term trades upon few trading sessions. 25-day EMA with 50-day EMA. Use this to identify medium-term trade upon few weeks. 50-day EMA with 100-day EMA. EMA used to identify trades that last upon few months. 100-day EMI with 200-day EMI. Use this to identify long-term trades, investment opportunities. Some of them can even last for a year or more. Remember, longer the time frame, the lesser the number of trading signals. Here is an example of 25 into 50 EMA crossover rule. Needless to say, a MA crossover system can be applied for intraday trading. For example, one could use a 15 into 30 minutes crossover to identify intraday opportunity, as more aggressive trader could use a 5 into 10 minutes crossover. You may have heard this popular saying in the market, the trend is your friend. When the moving averages help you identify this friend. Remember, moving average is a trend following system. As long as there is a trend, the moving average works brilliantly. It does not matter which time frame you use or which crossover combination you use. So the key takeaways from this chapter are, the first one, a standard average calculation is a quick approximation of a series of number. In an average calculation where the latest data point is included, the oldest is excluded, called as moving average. A simple moving average gives equal weightage to all data points in the series. An exponential moving average scales the data according to its newness. Recent data gives the maximum weightage and the oldest gets the least weightage. For a practical purpose, use the EMA as opposed to SMA. This is because EMA gives more weightage to the recent data point. The outlook is bullish when the current market price is greater than EMA. The outlook turns bearish when the current market price turns lesser than EMA. In a non-trading market, moving average may result in whipsaw, thereby causing frequent losses. To overcome this, an EMA crossover system is adopted. In a typical crossover system, the price chart is overloaded with two EMAs. The shorter EMA is faster to react, while the longer EMA is slower to react. The outlook turns bullish when the fast EMA crosses and is above the slower EMA. Hence, one should look at buying the stock. The trade lasts upon a point where the fast EMA starts going below the slower EMA. The longer the time frame one chooses for a crossover system, the lesser the trading signals. So this is all about the moving averages. If you gain a lot of knowledge, share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.